You know, we appreciate you being a part of our family every morning. Kerry Charles has been a part of our family here at Fox 8 for 7 years. Today, we have to say goodbye. He's heading to WAGA in Atlanta, Georgia. A great thing for you. Sad for us.
Yeah, it is sad. I can't believe it's been 7 years.
Time
just flies.
Feels like
it's
70.
It's so much fun.
It feels like 70.
This is not a roast, Emily.
Said with love.
We hate to see you go because you have meant so much, not only to us, but also to the community, from your involvement in the schools to the, you know, the haircuts for kids, to the things that you did with your fraternity and the sororities too that are local, you know. I mean, you embrace this community and the community embraced you back. And I think that's what we're going to miss.
I'll tell you the thing that was interesting. I mentioned it in a piece with the Carolina Peacemaker, is that when we joined the morning show, Katie Nordine and myself, it was expanding. And so when you have a team that's been together for years, it can be interesting and people wonder what's going to happen. And then after the dust settled, everybody said, okay, this is a team. We're all going to be here together. And so it's been great.
Yeah, I said, who is this guy coming in? And I learned very quickly, this guy is one of the few people that does a lot of things well. It's hard to find somebody who can do a lot of things, from anchoring to reporting to live anchoring in the field, to conventions, at all these big stories that you covered and brought them home to people. And beyond that, I think the thing that, I don't know that people get this on TV, is your kindness. The way you reach out to other people, whether it's kids on the street, whether it's people in the newsroom. He is one of the kindest people in broadcasting, truly. Reaches out and reaches out to other people.
Yeah. And if any journalism student wants to take notes on how to do a live shot, watch this guy.
Right. Well, that's nice.
Yes.
That's
really good. I mean, he is the cream of the crop when it comes to live reporting. That is no easy feat.
It's especially when you weren't expecting it.
Did you pay her to do
that's the thing, though. I think the community knows you in a certain way, and we know you in another way, and that's where I think so many people are going to miss you in such a certain way in this community. And I know Greensboro, High Point, Winston, we know what we've got, and I certainly hope Atlanta knows what they're going to get.
Thank you.
Hey, take a look at this. We always like to look back. Here's a look at some of the moments from Kerry's time here at Fox 8.
I have worked in several communities throughout the country, but the Triad is very special to me. My mother was born not too far from here, and I have a lot of family who still live in this area.
Fox 8's Kerry Charles shows you how Piedmont County.
Our Kerry Charles is live in D.C.
Hey, we were connecting with North Carolinians
in Charleston, South Carolina, at the site of Wednesday's unthinkable tragedy.
Live from Washington, D.C. for the 50th anniversary of the March on Washington.
This is the monument, the main attraction of this memorial.
We are here standing outside of the Cube Box.
I'm Kerry Charles in Greensboro. Thanks for watching Fox 8.
Kerry Charles came to me with the idea of him bringing a group of young men into the barbershop for us to get some haircut services, kind of boost the morale in hopes it's going to help them with their school. It's just been a phenomenal response from the community. Kerry Charles helped me to understand that it's sometimes the little things that we do have a bigger impact.
Good morning to you, everybody. We're glad you're with us. I'll get down here, and I may not be able to get up. And Weatherly, let's see. And then they say, what they say is, it feels so good in here. It's not hot.
He's been complaining about the heat, Emily.
Didn't eat dinner, so I have some chips. Tom Brady gave me a honey bun, and we didn't know the story was coming up. So.
I tried to take it.
Okay, I'm going to click. You talk.
Oh.
There.
Oh, this should be
okay. So we have high pressure right here going across. And then it's down here as well. Can you advance to the next screen?
I bought some ties recently, and I put this thing on while we were in the locker room. And I said, hey, I think this is a boy's tie.
My menu, relatively simple. We'll do potato salad from scratch, dressing rolls, and
For 8 people, how many should I get?
Keep going, trying to see if we can replicate this number right here. That's a good looking group. So my 7 years at Fox 8 have been all about growth, personally and professionally. So I want to say thanks to all of those who invested in me and made this time worthwhile. I'd like to begin with my family in Ohio, Texas, and all throughout North Carolina, the Reverend Alfonso McGlynn, the many immigrants who stopped me in the grocery store to tell me they were watching and paying attention to the pacing of my words and how they'd rolled off of my tongue. I learned I was helping them with their English. Thank you to the managers who brought me to Fox 8 and those who kept me here and support my next move. Nate, who cleans the building and has been so kind since we met during my interview. The crew, of course, who you see on air, and the many names you will never know, like the folks here behind the camera, those throughout the building, the photographers in the field, those who organized, and those who attended a memorable send-off Saturday night. And my sincere thanks to you for watching, whether it was on an old floor model TV, a fancy 4K flat screen, or on your mobile device. Thank you so much for trusting me with the news of the day, allowing me to be part of your community, and for all of the love through the years, particularly in this last week. It's been very special. I want to wish you the very best of luck to you, your family, and your dreams, and the same to each and every one of you. Thank you so, so much.
Thank you very much.
This has been great.
And here's your cake.
This has been great. This is sweet.
I don't know if you can see the cake. It's cartoon.
This is nice.
Cartoon carrot.
Bitmoji there. Yes. I love that thing.
Where do you get shades like that? I don't know.
I need some. I tell you what, guys, this has been so much fun. I'm going to take so much energy. I've learned something from each and every one of you. I've become a better person from my time here and have learned about being a part of a community versus just coming here and doing the job we do.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I got to ask. One food from here you're going to miss going to Atlanta. Atlanta is full of food, but what are you going to miss from here? The one thing.
Oh, I tell you, I just got introduced to this last night.
Yeah.
Sushi rolls.
Yeah.
There's chicken and rice, and then it's done. It's like a sushi roll.
Yeah.
Done with collard greens.
Oh, my God.
I bet you anything Atlanta's going to have that for you.
Yeah, or if not,
you can find somebody to whip
it up. But that'll bring you back.
Yeah. And I will be back from time to time.
Yes.
So say hello if you see me.
Karen, thank you very much. Best of luck to you, sir.
Yes.
Thank you very much. We're back in just a moment here on Fox 8.